The Uganda Martyrs Day celebrations at Namugongo Catholic Shrine was animated by the Jinja Diocese with Bishop Charles Martin Wamika as the main celebrant. His sermon rotated around the theme of Lord, increase our faith. He urged Catholics to emulate the faith of Uganda martyrs and stop being shy of their faith.
Trouble is many Catholics are too shy. I can look around here and see. If you don't share your faith, it will slowly die and soon it will be dead. Believe in yourself. 2003, send the martyrs up in heaven to come here so that people don't go back as they came. So they're a little bit changed.
It's at the Holy Mass that Bishop Anthony Ziwa, the chairperson of the Uganda Episcopal Conference, urged government to prevail over the increased gun violence, which has claimed several lives in the country by imposing strict regulations.
Our request to government and to the commander-in-chief to have stricter measures imposed on the use of guns in this country for both the security agents and private owners of guns.
Ziwa extended condolences to the country upon losing scores of UPDF soldiers in Somalia who were overrun by Al-Shabaab militants.
I'd like to convey our condolences to His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Uganda, him as the Commander-in-Chief of the Uganda People's Defense Forces, on the death of Uganda soldiers who were recently killed in Somalia. Condolences go to all members of the families of the fallen men.
The Archbishop of Kampala Diocese, Paul Semwogerere, hailed the legacy of Uganda martyrs for their impact on the education sector. Semwogerere noted that the number of academic institutions which have been opened in the legacy of Uganda martyrs can't be taken for granted.
The martyrs have impacted the world on matters of education, and that's the reason the conference elected a university after the Uganda Martyrs, to train leaders with values that serve the church and the world in virtue and wisdom.
In his address to the congregation, which was delivered by the Prime Minister Robin Anabanja, President Museveni hailed the contribution of Uganda martyrs to the spread of Christianity in the country. He also condemned reckless driving on roads which claimed lives of pilgrims who were trekking to Namugongo.
I want to register my regret concerning the incident of reckless driving at Kamuri roundabout, which inflicted injuries to some of the Baramazi from Busowa Catholic Parish, Bugiri District. I wish those in the hospital quick recovery, and caution motorists and border riders to drive carefully and respect the Baramazi and the other pedestrians on road.
Museveni rallied the faith to embrace government's wealth creation programs to alleviate poverty from their households. He urged households to use the parish development model to walk out of subsistence production.
Subsistence farming fosters poverty because besides the food, there are other human needs that must be satisfied, such as shelter, medicine, clothes, education, transport, etc. These can only be obtained with money. You cannot maintain a status of manless in a modern economy. The parish development model and the wealth funds are aimed at increasing the number of wealth creators engaged in production in the four sectors of commercial agriculture, industries, services, and ICT.
The Chawazinga of Busoga region, William Wilberforce Kahumbula Gabulana Diope IV, committed on behalf of the kingdom to safeguard the legacy of martyrs, especially the two who came from Busoga. He also lauded government for establishing a good environment for worship.
We shall safeguard what the martyrs stood for, such that their endeavors don't die in vain.
Report compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news.